All right, and I'm talking to
Kevin Ranft. I'm an AFSCME Local 4041 member, and I'm also a correctional officer for the state of Nevada.
All right. And what brings you out here today?
Biggest thing today was the budget cuts, and we got to stay focused on restructuring these budget cuts, because every time, approximately every 4 years, state employees get the brunt of balancing the budget on our backs. We are first citizens of Nevada, taxpayers of Nevada, and we are state employees. But people think of us as second-class citizens, and that needs to stop. So we have to balance the budget every single time on state employees, and that needs to come to a halt. The biggest thing we see is state employees coming together on the lunch hour today and showing unity, whether they're members or non-members. And we have a vision, and that vision is to restructure with the help of both the Assembly and the Senate to come together and say, it's time to have a vision to restructure the budget of Nevada. And go ahead.
Oh, go ahead.
Oh, I'm just saying there's ways of doing that, and that's, there's well, we talked about it today, and that's responsible spending, different tax structures that need to be reorganized. Like Barbara Buckley said last night, we're 1960 tax structure, and this is the fastest growing state in the nation. But yeah, we're still running off those structures, and it's just wrong.
Well, I guess
if everybody can grab a thing, come on over here.
I'm gonna move over here, guys. I'm sorry. I guess following on another question. What would you say to those that feel that everybody's taking a hit? I mean, we are, economically speaking, we may be a fast growth state, but we are taking a financial hit. I mean, everybody's taking cuts. Why can't you guys as well?
Absolutely, we have taken cuts many, many times before. We have the least state employees out of every state in the nation. Doing welfare, for example, has 600 caseload files for one caseworker for a welfare. I mean, we as correctional officers are we're not paid that well. We have the highest ratio to inmate per correctional officer in the nation. Okay, we have taken our cuts. We put our lives on the line every single day because of these cuts. And it needs to stop. It needs to be restructured. And these legislators today, we applaud them for what they've done, coming together and finding the necessary things to balance the budget in this time of crisis. And we applaud them. And that is, the bigger picture is just changing the budget and having that vision to change the budget. And I think Barbara Buckley said it well. And she will not go through this again. She will have change. And that is the bigger picture.
So on that topic, on that issue there, do you feel that... we're not going to do this again as talk about closing prisons as you work in the correctional and being a correctional officer, closing prisons, possibly, cutting, police forces. I mean, is that the way of the future for now from your perspective? Or do you feel
that's completely wrong to close prisons and to even look at releasing these inmates early or giving them additional ways out? They're in the prison for a reason, and they need to be there to protect the society. I mean, we're there to protect the citizens, and that's our number one goal. Mm-hmm. And if they're out, crime's going to go up. Recidivism, they're going to come right back to the prison system. So that means, again, we're closing down the prison, so what, we could build a new prison or reopen a prison that we already shut down? It's a temporary fix, it's a band-aid, it needs to stop.
Well, thank you very much for your time, and hope you don't bake out here tonight, today.
Again, the biggest message is budget change, new vision for the budget, and we want to thank these assembly and legislators, the assembly and the Senate, for coming together and making their decisions today to save Nevada State Prison and giving us our cost of living like we are citizens and taxpayers of the state.
Thank you very much, sir.